Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So it's that time of the month now for the last weekly check-in for the month. And this is for week 4 of March. So I do have a bunch of stuff ready to go here. So yeah, let's try not to make this long and let us begin. So I have all my list here. My stickers all ready to go. I have a couple bills here. I actually have quite a lot of bills paid for here. So yeah, let's zoom you guys in and we shall begin. The first one was on the 26th actually. So let's flip through here. So that was the iCloud storage for March 26th. Okay. And then next up is, on the same day, is my bank fees of $15.95. All right, next up is on the 28th. This is also both of these stickers. So yeah, I did pay two of my credit cards. So that's my Visa card of $100 and my MasterCard again of $100. Yeah, I did an extra payment this month for my MasterCard. And then on the next part here is another color. So Love 365 was on the 29th. And then Spotify was on the 30th. Okay, so now we're gonna go as per usual according to legend here. So I have an eating out, an unbudgeted expense, and an online purchase. So for the eating out, I have here two expenses, and that was on the 29th and 31st, so $10, both were McDonald's actually. So on the 29th, it's right here, and then the 31st, okay, and then next up is unbudgeted. I have a lot actually. So for the first one, it was an EB Games expense. No, it was not a game. And then next up is the App Store, and that was on the 25th. Off $8.80. Next is Amazon on the 23rd. No, it's not in my budget. It's not in my accounted budgeted. Why did I do that first? Whatever. And then next up is miscellaneous on the 31st. This one wasn't for me, so it's an unbudgeted expense. And then finally is my online purchases. So the first one was on the 24th. Wow, do I have no day where I didn't spend anything? It's because I've been home since this day. And then the next one is MWave on the 29th. Wow, all of my purchases are on this end. Wow, I wonder if I have no I have one. Okay, oh yeah, and let's see here. So this was payday. This was, and then envelope stuffing actually was on the 28th. And then no spend for this day as well. Cool. So that was that. Okay, so now we flip onto the weekly check-in page here. And we are right here. So I have all the papers here anyway for the what I've spent for. So for eating out, I spent 10 plus 15, so that's $25. And then the next one, so no beauty, no fur babies, no entertainment, and no stationery. So for online purchases, which is the next one, I did $80. All right, and because this time was payday, I'll just have to grab my blue pen here. I'll actually just flip it here just so it's easier for me to look at. So from last week, we'll basically subtract the ones I've spent on here. Okay, so I had 25 remaining last week, and then I spent 25, so that's 0. And then beauty is $30, since there was nothing spent. This one is 24. This one is $10. And this one is 0. What I hate about how complicated this is, I spent more than what I had basically last week. So actually, we'll just leave this blank and just, let's just leave it blank. Actually, where's my green pen? What I will do is, nothing. We'll leave it at that. All right, so for last week, I had, at least when the government gives me my pace, the unemployed people, this one will be easier because I'll do my cash stuffing in one day in the month because we get paid all in one go. So yeah, anyways, at least it won't be as hard to budget this now because of the me spending more than what was remaining last week. But I actually had enough because of the payday. For eating out, yeah, so I had 0 and then I had a $30 cash drop. For things like this, actually, I'll probably just leave it red for the ones where I spent more than what I had. So for beauty, I had a $20 cash drop. And then for babies, I had $15. And then for entertainment, I had $10 cash drop. And then for stationery, I had $10. So for this one, I'll put what I had actually. So my cash drop, what I had last week was $50. Plus my other $50. And then in black ink, I'll put what I had left. So 50 to 50 minus 80, so that should be 20. So the black ink signifies what I should have. Okay, that was easy. All right, and let's actually just check that off. All right, I'll just grab my wallet and let's see if everything matches up. I'll also just quickly grab the coins here. All right, so for eating out, I should have $25 left in here. So 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 30. I should have 30, not 25. What am I talking about? And yeah, it looks like I broke it down just so it's easier for me. And the fact that the only reason why I have a lot of, like, I've been buying food was through Skip the Dishes. Yeah, online purchasing for food. All right, next up is beauty. So 30 plus 20 should, I should have $50 in here. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Neat. All right, so now for fur babies, so 24 plus 15, I should have 39 in here. So 10, 20, 30, 35, 36, 7, 38, 39. Okay, so everything matches up. And then for entertainment, 10 plus 10 is 20. So 10, 15, 20. Online purchases, I should have $20 left in here, which is accurate. And then for stationery, I have $10 in here, supposed to be. Right, so my numbers match up. So now we set these things aside. And I'll just flip onto this page right here. And I will list down my unbudgeted transactions. So on March 22nd was EB Games. And that was 40-15. 03-23 is Amazon. 25-83. And then 03-25 is App Store. Of $8.80, and then 03-31 is miscellaneous of $18. Cool. And then we'll just calculate how much I spent on unbudgeted stuff. So total. Okay, let's see. Where's my calculator? So $12.92. Plus $19.37, plus $3.94, $17.50, $40.15, $25.83, $8.80, $18. So that's $146.51 for my total. All right, and with that, I am done with my weekly check-in, my last weekly check-in for the month of March. All right, so that was that for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Once again, thank you guys for watching. Thumbs up if you like this video. Subscribe to my channel for more budgeting related videos, and remember to keep on shining. Bye.